Hello Martians, Ralphie here, Whiskey Review 116, and I'm going to set you a little challenge at the start of this review. Pronounce that title of this blended whiskey. It's the one in the red letters. You can forget the black letters, just the red letters. Let's see how you get on at pronouncing it. I'll give you a few seconds. No, nowhere near it. That's a bit more like it, yeah. Ah, you're getting there now. You're getting there now. Because you realise, you Maltese, that when it comes to the translation of Gaelic into English, you cannot do it phonetically. It is, in fact, completely different from what it looks. This whiskey is Chevek. Not T. Behag. It's Chevek, full name Chevek Nanealin, which means, oh, big stretch, well worth the trip. Lovely. There we go. Chevek Nanealin, little lady of the Isles. Chevek is little one. And if you go to the west coast of Scotland and the Isles, if you ask for a little one when it comes to whisky, if they are true Scots, they will give you a big one. And if they happen to be visiting you and you do not give them enough whisky, these Highlanders and Islanders will look forlornly into the glass and say, "Och aye. If a fly were to drop in there, they could tread water no problem at all. In fact, they'd touch the bottom." Denoting that you're being miserable with your whisky. It's an old Gaelic hospitality thing that when you have very little in the way of worldly possessions, in fact, applies to the whole of Scotland or wherever you go in the world. If you don't have much of anything, whatever you do have, If you're generous with it, then it denotes your humanity, your generosity, and your hospitality. So there you have it. Chevek, it's part of the Prabnalin Whiskey Company, based on Skye. The company does not actually own a distillery, although they are building one. This little whiskey is not out there in big quantities. It's what's part of a niche blended whisky market, they call it, and along with some malt blends by the name of Portugal, but more about that later. And this is a very good quality blended whisky. In fact, I started sipping it last night and writing up my little tasting notes as I do, and I really had to put the stopper on it because I was getting onto my second glass and thinking, this is a very Moorish whiskey. You pour more and you want more. It's 40% malt content. If you're interested in looking at the website, you basically Google or Yahoo or whatever, GaelicWhiskey.co.uk. And that will, if you spell Gaelic wrong, don't worry about it. In fact, I'll probably add the link to the notes that accompany this vlog. And good luck to this whisky company. They are committed to providing jobs and industry to the economies in the West Coast Islands of Scotland, which generally there has always been high unemployment and a lack of affordable housing, but that is because of Britain, Little Britain PLC, simple as that. Now, I emailed Prabnalin to ask them what goes into their whisky, and I get this lovely email back from Rosalind. Says, "Dear Ralphie, many thanks for your email. We don't actually disclose the whiskies, fair enough, that are used in our blends. All we would say is that for the Portugal, which is their malted, mixed malt, their malt blends, blended malt, The whiskies are the malts used are from the West Coast and Highland region. Is there any other information required? Kind regards. So there we have it. We have checked it out. Now they're not saying very much, but it's quite understandable because when you're a small independent whiskey company, if you've got a cracking good whiskey, your competitors want to know what it is. So either they can do it themselves or stop you getting the whiskies that work. That's competition for you. So what do we think of this? Half the output of this particular blended whiskey goes to France and Nova Scotia in Canada, where the very discerning whiskey drinkers to be found. Discerning? Why? Let's put our nose into this and see. There is a delicious, in fact, it's stunning, complex honey, hazelnut, touch of walnut going on in here. I'm sure I can smell Isle of Jura for a start. There is a distant hint of peat and smoke, but it's hard to pin things down. There's spice in there, there's fruit in there, there's a hell of a lot going on in this. It is, by the way, as it says on the label, unchill filtered. How delightful to get a blended whiskey which is not chill filtered. It doesn't say whether there's caramel in it or not, but frankly, I don't believe there is. That's my personal opinion. And this whiskey is lifted as a result of that. The nose alone is well worth getting a bottle. It's delightful. Taste-wise, it's a whiskey, when you have it in your tongue, you don't want to let it go. This gives many malt whiskies a run for their money. There we go. Taste-wise, there is a very measured, articulate arrival of crisp, butterscotched barley sugar, beautiful grain, 40% malt. Where's the grain whiskey in there? It's your heart, you're struggling to find it because this is so well put together. I find this very old-fashioned, very old school, old world quality blended whiskey. The spices are suggested, the fruit is suggested, there's little echoes, there's little whispers of the Talisker's and the Islay whiskies. It is frankly stunning, actually. If you're adding water, I recommend very little water. It will open this whiskey up. This whiskey will continue to develop over 15, 20 minutes. As I mentioned earlier, the company based on Skye are looking to build a distillery, and I really do wish them good fortune, best of luck in doing so, because Britain is different from the United States, where there's now 200 artisan distilleries. In America is a culture of what you can do. In Scotland and Britain is a culture of what you can't do, and it's so hard for entrepreneurs, for small, experienced whiskey makers to actually get permission to successfully open a distillery, and that is such a shame. And it's all down to culture and vested interests in Little Britain. There we go. Well, that's not going to be sitting there for long. If you want to know more, ralphie.com. See you soon.